r/AskReddit created by routinereddit. Serious, what are some of the creepiest declassified documents made available to the public? Operation Northwoods. Proposed false flag attacks against American civilians / targets carried out by the CIA and blamed on Cuba in 1962. Thankfully, JFK said heck no and shut that crap down. Apparently, JFK even demoted the guy who proposed this on the spot. Thank God. Also, this means that this idea had to go through a long chain of command with many high-ranking people in the government agreeing to it. Do you know if this was when Alan Dulles was still running the CIA? If so, I'm not entirely surprised. Him and John Foster Dulles were some bizarre figures who enacted all sorts of problematic plans under Eisenhower. Dulles briefly lingered under JFK, if memory serves, but I think it was the Bay of Pigs that finally got him the boot. The Brothers by Stephen Kinzer does a great job of giving a biography of them and their actions under Eisenhower. Alan Dulles was head of the CIA, while his brother was Secretary of State, and it was a dangerous combination that led to the US supporting the overthrow of governments through a series of coups in places like Guatemala, Jacobo Arbenz, Iran, Mohammed Mossadegh, Indonesia, Sukarno, and the Congo, Patrice Lumumba. The intel community basically worshipped the memory of Dulles and everything he did. He was pretty much the father of modern intelligence gathering, didn't give a crap how it was done, and instilled roots in multiple branches and departments, some of which are still heavily embedded today. There's a reason most legit JFK assassin theorists still think the CIA is the closest, the most potential. Let's just say, when JFK fired Dulles, it sent a warning shot across government lifers, and at that point the intel community basically had no accountability, so they weren't too keen to have some pretty boy in office trying to chest thump. JFK isn't really liked much in intel community. One thing you don't even want to pretend to mess with is a government agent's penchant, especially multiple agencies' worth. Operation Lack, biological warfare testing done on US cities. Principally, the operation involved spraying large areas with zinc cadmium sulfide, which is very toxic. Many who were affected died of cancer and the testing was never followed up on. Most of the neighborhood's genetic makeup was messed up for no reason, and no apologies were made. My mom told me one time, she was living in California, they stated they were spraying to get rid of fruit flies / gnats. They woke up and all the fish in their tanks were bleeding out their eyes, and she also had a miscarriage a week later. That story always stuck with me and made me wonder, what in the crap did I just read? The reason that insane conspiracy theories can so easily take root, because reality can be so much worse. Ted Kaczynski, the Unabomber, was subjected to grueling, degrading psychological experiments while he was an underage student at Harvard. Whenever I see him brought up, I like to repost this, quoting /you/Yoffimajojo from this thread. At the start of the Cold War, Henry Murray developed a personality profiling test to crack Soviet spies with psychological warfare and select which US spies are ready to be sent out into the field. As part of Project Nkultra, he began experimenting on Harvard sophomores. He set one student as the control, after he proved to be a completely predictable conformist, and named him Lawful. Long story short, the latter half of the experiment involved having the student prepare an essay on his core beliefs as a person for a friendly debate. Instead, Murray had an aggressive interrogator come in and basically tear his beliefs to pieces, mocking everything he stood for, and systematically picking apart every line in the essay to see what it took to get him to react. But he didn't. It just broke him, made him into a mess of a person, and left him having to pull his whole life back together again. He graduated, but then turned in his degree only a couple years later, and moved to the woods where he lived for decades. In all that time, he kept writing his essay, and slowly, he became so sure of his beliefs, so convinced that they were right, that he thought that, if the nation didn't read it, we would be irreparably lost as a society. So, He set out to make sure that everyone heard what he had to say, and sure enough, Lawful's Industrial Society and Its Future has become one of the most well-known essays written in the last century. In fact, you've probably read some of it. Although, you probably know it better as the Unabomber Manifesto. People forget that Ted Kaczynski was a legitimate genius. He was the youngest math professor in the history of the University of California, Berkeley. Kind of in a hole though. Thanks y'all for correcting me. Anything involving Japan's Unit 731 during WWII. It was a military chemical and biological warfare division that experimented on POWs. The bit that gets me about this is that they got away with it. The US have them immunity in return for their records. And their records were pretty worthless too, Ike. They didn't have controls, so not much was gained in exchange for a huge capitulation of ethics. It's gosh dang disgusting. This always comes up when people mention Unit 731. I would love a source, if you've got one. I've tried to find one, and have been unsuccessful. Leave a like, comment, subscribe, and hit the bell for daily Reddit videos. Project Pluto is pretty horrific. The proposed use for nuclear-powered ramjets would be to power a cruise missile, called SLAM, for supersonic low-altitude missile. In order to reach ramjet speed, it would be launched from the ground by a cluster of conventional rocket boosters. Once it reached cruising altitude, and was far away from populated areas, the nuclear reactor would be made critical. Since nuclear power gave it almost unlimited range, the missile could cruise in circles over the ocean until ordered down to the deck for its supersonic dash to targets in the Soviet Union. The SLAM, as proposed, would carry a payload of many nuclear weapons to be dropped on multiple targets, making the cruise missile into an unmanned bomber. After delivering all its warheads, the missile could then spend weeks flying over populated areas at low altitudes, causing tremendous ground damage with its shockwave and fallout. When it finally lost enough power to fly and crash landed, the engine would have a good chance of spewing deadly radiation for months to come. The Russians have been developing hypersonic ramjet nuclear missiles, like, right now. I'm not a scientist, but they sound like they are pretty much indefensible. Lasers can't outrun the speed of light. Old idea with a very simple countermeasure. You make the missile spin, so the laser can't shoot at one spot on it constantly, which would be required if you want it to burn through the hull of the missile. Stronger lasers. Reflective surface like a disco ball. Even stronger lasers. Get this guy in the government as soon as possible. I think there was a lot of creepy things that came out when the East German Stasi files were released after the Berlin Wall fell. All citizens were allowed to view their own files and many were shocked to find out that their own relatives were informing on them because they had no choice, and various other things. A good movie about this is called Other People's Lives Edit. I got the name of the movie wrong. It's The Lives of Others for English speakers who want to watch it. It's called Lives of Others on Netflix. Katerina Witt, two-time Olympic gold medalist in figure skating from East Germany, had a Stasi file on her starting from when she was 8 years old. She even got spied on by fellow teammate, Ingo Stuhr, who was an active informant. Stuhr's Stasi past eventually got the best of him when he nearly got banned from the German national team for the 2006 Winter Olympic Games due to his activities. He was eventually allowed to still go, but was forbidden from wearing the German team colors. However, his reputation got restored in 2010, allowing him to wear the German uniform for the Winter Olympics. Gay bomb. It was a weapon speculated by the USA in the 90s that, when dropped, would release pheromones which would make the enemy attracted to each other. Edit, spelling. I love the idea that the enemy would just stop fighting a war and get their bang on. I mean, shouldn't we all at least give it a try? Back in the pile.